My name is Hannah and I'm a software developer living here in Accra. I'm talking about misconceptions about people who work in tech today. So let's do this. So the first misconception is that all tech people are rich. I like to think that a lot of people working in tech are getting paid a good amount of money, but doesn't necessarily mean that they are rich. If someone is working in Accra, Ghana and earning about 20,000 cedis per month, it doesn't necessarily mean that the person is taking home 20,000 cedis every month, because taxes are crazy in this country and you may be paying as high as even more than 5,000 cedis in taxes. You may consider that you have a lot of like cash left, but it doesn't necessarily mean that you are rich all the time, because rent, food, transportation, and lots of expenses are very high. So just calm down when it comes to the idea that all tech people are rich. A lot of tech people that you may know are not necessarily earning this 20,000 cedis that I just mentioned. A lot of people are just beginning and they are earning somewhere around 5,000 cedis or sometimes even 3,000 cedis depending on the company. So it is not generic that all people working in tech are rich. It may even take someone a very long time to rise up the ranks into becoming a senior software developer where they can really see that they are making a lot amount of money. But starting out, it's not so easy and it's sometimes very rough, and people have to go to so many companies to actually land a company that pays them right, especially in this country, because a lot of companies in Ghana are not paying developers the fair amount that they have to pay. Maybe it's just this country, but here in Ghana, not all tech people are rich. Another misconception has to do with the idea that you need a computer science degree to get into tech. This is to point out that I know someone who has a chemistry degree and is working in tech and doing so well at it. So the idea doesn't necessarily lie on the computer science degree. Any degree at all is just about enough to get you into tech. The reason why a lot of people would go for people who have degrees and not necessarily computer science degree is because they have projects to show that they know what they claim to say they know. So if someone is self-taught and does the same amount of work that someone doing a computer science degree is doing, there's no blocker to not hire that person. At the end of the day, it doesn't lie on the degree that you have, but it lies on the skills that you possess. That is why I keep saying that in tech, it doesn't necessarily mean that you have to get like a master's degree, a PhD to be able to get into tech. You have a lot of avenues around you and you have a lot of opportunities to even get into tech without necessarily getting a computer science degree. So the idea of being a software developer means that you have to put in lots of time into developing your skills and a lot of dedication into making sure that you are good at what you say you are good at. And that is why it's always good to go after the skill other than the degree, but the degree is good enough to get you an interview. They are both good options, depends on where you want to start from. It's a lot easier if you have a computer science degree, because then they don't even question the idea that you don't have any skill in programming at all, because definitely you have programming skills. If you don't have a computer science degree, you are equally capable or competent to get into tech. It doesn't necessarily lie on computer science degrees. The third misconception is that all you need to do is learn to code, and this is such a no-brainer, but there's a twist to it. So the idea about getting into tech primarily is to learn to code. It's like to learn to write code and write good code, I mean, with time. But tech has really evolved to the point that you don't necessarily have to learn to code to get into the field of tech. Now, don't get me wrong here. If you are looking to be a developer, that is when we are talking about coding and learning to write code very well and all that stuff. But if we are talking of the broad topic of tech, so you want to say be a designer, being a UI UX designer is also the same as being in tech, because tech is really wide and there are lots of fields or lots of facets to it. So you can be a designer in tech, you can be a technical writer, like a lot of things that I've even talked about in a previous video that I did. And this is to say that if you're looking to be a developer, like if you're looking to get into programming, then that is where we can say that you are required to learn to code to get into tech. Another aspect that I want to touch about is money. I think that a lot of people, if we are talking about developers and designers, if you are looking at people who make a lot of money, would always go with developers. So if you are trying to decide on which part of tech to actually join, if money means anything to you and you would want to consider that as a factor in deciding like these things, you would want to consider getting into a difficult part of it. There's a quote that says that if we are going to do it, then we are going to do it hard.
We choose to go to the moon in this decade and do the other things. Not because they are easy, but because they are hard.
So if you want to go into it and then get the money out of it, then you might as well consider the coding part of getting into tech. So point number four says that tech is hard. And I'm sorry to tell you that that is not a misconception. It's like we know that it's hard, but yet we want to do it. Tech is hard, and that is true. Now, talking about what actually makes tech hard, is because technology evolves very quickly. So it's like you know a set of skills today and tomorrow it's obsolete. Like one thing I really found weird was that there are tools that you are using today and tomorrow you go back and it's deprecated and then you can't use it. The developers of those applications will tell you that they don't support it anymore, but they are the ones who did it because they want to move on to a newer version or to upgrade to a newer version. That's why they do all these things. And that's what sometimes makes tech hard, because then you will have to learn a lot of skills very quickly, but it's not so easy on someone who is trying to navigate their way into the field, and it can be very hard at times. And another aspect that makes tech hard is the idea that a lot of clients or a lot of people who work with developers have like little tolerance to the idea that developers need time to be able to build the stuff that you require them to do, and they come out with these deadlines and stuff, and it can be very overwhelming sometimes, but it's all part of the game. Like I said, we knew that this is how it is and we still decided to go ahead with it. So this is the life that we have chosen, and we are probably going to do this for a long time, as long as we still want to do this. Yeah. So if you have watched to this point, I want to say thank you for coming this far, and the fact that you've gotten to this point tells me that you like this video. So please consider liking this video and subscribing to the channel as well, and turn on your post notification button so that you can get a video whenever I upload. And to point number five is that AI is going to replace all developers. I think that the topic of AI is a little twisted. Developers are still essential, and it doesn't mean that AI is not good. AI is such a good tool that it makes my work so easy. It makes my life a little easy, but the idea that it's going to replace developers is a little outrageous. So there's so much that developers or people in tech do that AI may not necessarily reach that point just yet. So I think it's a little far-fetched to say that AI is wiping out all developers. AI is a good tool and it has come to live with us, but you should just take it a little easy on yourself in considering that you're not going to be relevant in the next 5 years. So go on to still learn that code and go on to still get better in your coding skills, and trust me, you're going to do so well in your career without even bothering yourself about the idea that AI is going to replace you. You are actually using AI to make your work a little efficient. So it's a good tool that can work well with you being in the picture. So there's nothing to worry about. Just go ahead and learn your code. This brings me to the end of today's video, and I want to say a big thank you to all my subscribers and to you who is currently watching this video right now. Like I said, please subscribe to the channel, and I will see you in my next video. Bye for now.